Welcome to the Slow Home Studio. January is stair month, and today we're going to be looking at different ways that you can detail a guard out of drywall.
That's right. It's called a closed guard. And in the last couple of episodes, we were looking at the treads and the risers and the stringers, and now we're going to focus on the thing that stops you from falling out and off the stair and hitting your head. And the sort of classic piece when you don't have an open balustrade is to just detail that as a piece of wall that has actually just been cut off on the side, and we can either do it in a flat way or we can have it with a curve.
Yep.
Like that.
And I think the trick with all of this stuff is that you really want to make sure that you declunk it, because if it's the proportion and thickness, that's my new technical word for drywall guards, is you want to declunk it, because if it looks like a chunky, horrible piece of wall, then it's not going to look detailed very properly. But there are some tricks you can do to make it look light and airy. And in this example, you can see what the architect has done. This piece of drywall here becomes the guard, but then it returns at the bottom, and you can see he's articulated just that little bit of a reveal on the side so that you read that all as one object that then becomes coplanar with the ceiling. You can even see underneath here they've cut away the bottom of the stair outline, and it makes it feel lighter and more integrated.
Right. I would say that what they're doing is integrating the treads with the guardrail themselves into one object. This is doing the exact opposite, separating it out. Here we have an open riser stair, and we just have the treads spanning in between one wall and another wall. But again, notice how there's that piece where it offsets and then comes down as an object.
Yeah, it's all about these little details, and I think that really makes it look really, really good. And I think here's another example where you notice at the bottom that the wall is treated to consider as running underneath that bottom last tread. If the architect had detailed that as the dark flooring all the way to the floor, we would lose that effect of this wall kind of grabbing the stair, wrapping up, and then wrapping around the corner onto the catwalk above.
That's right. And it is, I think, interesting that this actually becomes part of another design within the entire house as a whole.
It's declunked, I would say. Yeah.
All right. To learn more about declunking and the Slow Home principles, follow us on Twitter.
See you next time.